U.S. stock futures are flat on Thursday. Economic data, speeches, and oil will be in focus. In Washington, D.C., Senate Republicans plan to release their version of health care reform legislation at 9:30 a.m. Eastern Time. And there are also reports that the U.S. president will meet with a second round of tech executives and venture capitalists. Also sticking to D.C., the Federal Reserve Board is set to release the results from the latest supervisory stress test conducted as part of the Dodd-Frank Act. Now, on the economic data front, jobless claims hit 241,000, just above expectations. And we will be getting the FHFA House Price Index, as well as the Kansas City Fed Manufacturing Index later today. In the previous session, U.S. indices closed mixed with shares in the energy, telecommunications, as well as materials sector, ending on a negative note. Meanwhile, shares in the pharma, biotech, and life sciences, as well as software and services and semiconductor sectors, gained traction. As for your advancers and decliners, 66% of S&P 500 constituents traded lower yesterday. In company news, Oracle beat on top-line earnings expectations and shares jumped in extended trading. Now, the company beat earnings estimates for the fiscal fourth quarter, and revenues of $10.9 billion were also better than consensus estimates. Guidance was also rosy for Oracle, with the company forecasting 4 to 6% sales growth. Moving on to Berkshire Hathaway, the company has agreed to acquire Home Capital for $400 million Canadian dollars, and this is for shares of Home Capital through a private placement. The deal will provide a new credit facility of $2 billion Canadian dollars to Home Trust Company. Looking at overseas markets, the Nikkei was off 0.14%, the Hang Seng off nearly 0.1%, and South Korea's Kospi gaining 0.5%. European indices are lower on Thursday. Moving on to the S&P 500, it is under pressure, and short positions below 2440 are preferred, with targets at 2426 and 2421 in extension. As for the Nasdaq, the key resistance stands at 2810, and for the Dow Industrials, it is under pressure.